Hey everyone, I'm Sid. I'm a program manager on the Python AI and ML tools team, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can supercharge your Azure ML development through Visual Studio Code. So let's get started. Just a little bit of an overview. We are going to first start by creating some Azure Machine Learning compute resources. We're then going to seamlessly connect to these resources from within VS Code. And then finally, we're going to run and interactively debug a local training job directly on the remote compute that we're connected to. So let's start by first going to VS Code and talking a little bit about the project that we're working on. So I'm in VS Code now. You'll see I have this project open. It's called PyCon MNIST. And just a little bit of a background as to what we're doing here. We're going to be training a neural network with TensorFlow to classify handwritten digits. And we're going to be training this neural network using the famous MNIST dataset that many of you may be familiar with if you've done or dabbled in machine learning before. And so here I have a training script. I have a utility script with some helper methods, as well as an environment YAML file that I can to define the environment that I'm going to be working in. Now, one of the options that I have is I can actually do this training directly on my local machine, right? So I can run this Python script in the Conda environment that I have here. However, right now I'm on my laptop, and my laptop, unfortunately, is a CPU-based machine with very little memory, and I think it's four cores. And so what I expect to happen, just given the memory that I have and given the memory that I have and the cores that I have available, is that I expect this to actually take quite a bit of time. So instead, what I want to do is I want to create a compute resource through Azure Machine Learning while, again, just being within VS Code here. And I'm going to do so through the Azure Machine Learning extension. And once I have that compute resource, I can use that instead to run my training job instead of my laptop, as I mentioned. What I can do is I can navigate to the Azure tab on the left-hand side. You'll see that when I open this tab, I'm presented with the Azure Machine Learning pane. Here, I have a list of subscriptions that are tied to my Azure account. And then for these subscriptions, I have a list of workspaces. So just really quickly, for all of you that may be unfamiliar with Azure ML, a workspace is a top-level resource in AML that is used to manage and organize all of the artifacts and resources that I create through the service. So with this expanded, you'll see that I have a list of artifacts here, such as datasets, experiments, computing resources, environments, again, all related to the Azure Machine Learning service and grouped under this workspace. So now I want to get started with creating a compute. I can list the compute instances, which you can think of as managed VMs for me to make use of. Here I have a list of compute instances already. You see some are stopped, some are running, one's in a restart fail state. That's probably something I should take a look at after I finish with this demo. But what I can do to create a compute is I can right click on this create compute instance node. I can choose the create compute instance option. I can then provide it with a name. So I'm going to call it PyCon 2021 demo. And now here I can search for the compute or the VM size that I'm looking for based off of different things that I know. So if I knew the name of the VM size, I can just search for it directly. You'll see that I know that I might want an NC6, so I can find it that way. Alternatively, if I know that I want a GPU, I can filter for all of the computes that have a GPU available. And then finally, if for example, I want something that's 16 cores, right? So four times what I have on my laptop, I can just search for cores 16, and then you'll see here that I'm presented with a list of options, right? So I'm going to choose the standard D14 here, and I'm going to say that I don't want to enable SSH access. Now, remember that I mentioned earlier that we're going to be connecting to this compute. So keep that in mind here. I'm not enabling SSH access. I'm not doing anything in terms of opening ports, changing any network configurations, but eventually I should still be able to connect to this compute instance. So I'm going to say no. And now this compute is being created. It is going to take a little bit of time to create this compute. Luckily, I have one from before that I'm going to use instead. I'll show that to you right now. So I have this PyCon 2021 compute. And what I can do to connect to this compute is I can just right click on this node, choose the connect to compute instance option. And then you'll see here that a remote window is now being opened, where this remote window is connecting me from my local machine to the remote compute instance. Now, I talked a little bit about SSH access or the lack thereof here. Well, what's happening behind the scenes now is there are WebSockets. There's a WebSocket connection that's being established between my local machine and the compute instance, and that WebSocket connection and all of the information that's going to that through that WebSocket connection is also going through the Azure ML control plane. So the way in which kind of authorization and access credentials work is that it goes through the Azure ML control plane. I'm authenticated using my AAD credentials. What's awesome about this, when you think about it in comparison to SSH, is I can audit this, right? I can't share my AAD credentials with someone else. It's tied to my Azure account, and so I don't have to worry about things like leaked passwords or leaked certificates. And so I'm establishing a connection to this compute instance in a highly compliant and highly secure way. And the beauty of this now is that once I'm connected here, it's honestly just the same as it would be in regular VS Code, right? So I can do a number of things here, such as interact with the terminal, as you see here, interact with the file system, manage Git repos, use the debugger, use different kinds of extensions. And so what I'm going to start off with is I'm just going to go to my personal directory, right? So you'll see that's the user's son at the directory. And then I'm going to git clone the repo that I plan to work in, right? I'm just running this git clone command. It's going to clone the repo in this directory. That was really fast. Now if I drop this down in the file explorer, you'll see that that's there immediately. So I can just copy the path to this directory. And then I can open this folder now in VS Code. And so you'll see that this new folder is opening and we're establishing that remote connection again. But this is all happening really quickly because we're making use of existing servers that we've installed on the compute instance and the existing WebSocket connection that we have. All right, so now that I'm on the compute instance again and scoped to this folder, to my project folder, what I can do is I can open up my training script, and now I can run this training script as a job tracked through Azure ML, but directly on this compute instance. So the way that I would do that is I would right-click in this file here. I can choose this Azure ML run as experiment in Azure command, and then now I'm prompted to decide whether I want to run this remotely or locally. I'm going to say that I'm going to run this locally, as I mentioned. I'm going to say that yes, I do want to debug my experiment. And now I'm asked for an experiment. So what is an experiment? You can think of it as a way, as just a placeholder or a way in which I can group a number of different training runs. So I'm going to use this default experiment that I have. I now have to choose an environment. So just really quickly on environments, an environment in AML can be thought of as a way to package different conda or pip dependencies that you have. And these environments, when ran remotely or sometimes locally, can be either materialized as a conda environment or a Docker container. So in my case, I'm going to materialize this environment as a container in order to do this local run and be able to debug. Instead of using one of these curated environments that you see here, so those are all the ones that are prefixed with Azure ML, I'm just going to choose one that I've created from before, right? So it's called PyCon TensorFlow Debug. It contains all the right packages that I need. And in this case, for this demo, I'm not going to use a data set. It's outside of the scope of the demo. But if you are interested in data sets and wondering how you can use them, there's a ton of documentation that you can take a look at there. And so now here, finally, I just have this little JSON that gives me a bit of an overview as to what I'm going to be running. So again, it's tied to my default workspace. I'm going to run it locally. It's going to contain these packages. So TensorFlow, Azure ML, DebugPy, and then I can just hit Submit Experiment. And voila. So now you'll see that the experiment is being submitted and that my debug session is being set up. So my debug session is ready. I can now set breakpoints. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set a breakpoint here just to make sure I'm getting the run context correctly. I'm then going to set a breakpoint at the MNIST dataset download step. And then finally, I'm going to set a breakpoint at my epoch, right? So these are my training cycles. And then I'll just bring that up again and hit Start Debugger. And so now, when I hit Start Debugger, the Azure Machine Learning extension, what it's going to do is that it's going to run my experiment, as you see here. This is running in a Docker container on my compute instance that I'm connected to seamlessly, from within VS Code. And I immediately hit that breakpoint that I set to see the run context. So I want to make sure that I'm getting the run context correctly. I am. That's awesome. And then what I'm also going to do is I'm going to output something to the debug console. So for example, I'm going to say print. That's not the debug console. This is the debug console. So I'm going to say print hello PyCon. And I'm going to output this to the debug console. You can imagine that I want to print that because I'm curious as to, or because I'm looking to get more information about the run that I'm doing. And then I'm going to hit play. And what's happening here is that it does take a little bit of time for the data to get prepared. But what I want to show you is as this job is running, I can actually track it through the Azure Machine Learning extension. So you'll see I have that experiments node. If I just search for default, it's going to find the default experiment that I have here. And then you'll see that this is the run. This is the most recent run, run 71, that's happening right now. I can actually take a look at logs associated with this run. So if I go to the logs tab, find Azure ML logs, double click on this. This is going to stream this 70 driver log directly in my console, which is really cool too. So not only can I interactively debug, but I can also run this experiment and then stream logs directly in the console here. Now I just wait for all of the data preparation steps to take place, and then eventually I should hit the epoch breakpoint that I have set here. So you'll see that I hit this breakpoint that I set for the epoch, so I can just step over, and now I can debug the training cycle that's happening. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to unset these breakpoints and I'm going to hit play. Before I do that, one thing I forgot to mention from before, you remember how I typed hello PyCon in the debug console? That's actually now part of my driver log. So that's really cool because what I can do is I can debug variables. I can write what I want to the debug console, and then I can have that get saved as part of the artifacts associated with my run here. So I'm going to hit play and I'm just going to let this run. And so you'll see, this is just going to run through all of the different cycles. One thing I also want to mention is I can also set a breakpoint kind of as this is running, right? Because this is just looping as you see here. So I'm going to put one on the batch size. For example, if I see something going awry with my validation accuracy or my training accuracy, I can set a breakpoint there and now I can investigate what was happening. And then I can step through this code here. And then when I feel like I've diagnosed the issue that I'm seeing, I can unset that breakpoint and then just continue. And so this is going to run. And then once this completes, I can get outputs for this run. So I'm going to show that for a completed one. You'll see here that I have outputs, and then this is just the model that I can then use to serve as part of our Azure ML on, for example, an inferencing cluster. So just a quick recap of what we've done here. I created a compute through VS Code. I seamlessly connected to this remote compute, which was much more powerful than my laptop, using the Azure ML extension as well. And then finally, on this compute, I ran a local training job that I interactively debugged. And so, in terms of next steps, I would recommend checking out our newly published blog post where we talk a little bit about the compute instance and compute instances and how you can seamlessly connect to them, as well as some other entry points, for example, coming from the Azure ML Studio, for all of you that are familiar with that. Then I would recommend installing the AML extension and giving it a try, especially if you're an Azure user, someone who is starting to dabble kind of in the machine learning world, want to get your feet wet a little bit. Try this extension out and then please provide feedback to the team. We'd love to kind of know how you're using the extension, where we can improve this extension, and then we'd love to reach out to you directly as well if possible. So that's it from my end. Thank you so much. I hope to see you at the next PyCon. Cheers.